So our heating failed. I noticed that the radiators weren't getting hot, although the hot water was still working. So that was strange, but at least it meant that the boiler was not the problem. It turns out, of course, as is often the case, I think, in my experience, it turned out to be the three-way valve, this Honeywell three-way valve that can let the hot water from the boiler either go to the cylinder, the radiators, or both. Driven by this servo motor. And sure enough, I thought it would be the servo motor itself. Turned out to be one of the switches in the mechanism here, which was faulty. But that's replaced now and it's working again. I've marked this one up the same as I did the last one. You can see the position of this cam plate here. That's on the radiator side. If it's fully down, it's diverting water to the radiators. If it's fully up, it's diverting it to just the hot water cylinder. And if it's in the middle, of course, it's diverting it to both at the same time. So, yeah, cunning valves, but they do seem to be unreliable. At least this one's lasted just under, or just over 9 years. It's 9 years, 1 month, the last one. And this replacement hopefully will last at least that long, if not longer. And I'll put the cover back on, and this is good to go. So here's the power head from the three-way valve from our central heating. So I'll take it apart. I thought it would be the motor, but it turns out that it's not. So just loosen that screw there. I've probably taken this to bits. So synchronous motor comes out fine. It's cleverly done actually. There's only one screw over here. And the other tab on here just slides underneath this pressing on the plate. So nicely engineered for quick assembly. But I say, clicking into the mains, it works absolutely fine. So that's not the problem. It turns out that the problem is one of the switches. And this plate is held on, just pushed through the back plate and then just twisted over. So I've straightened those tabs and this lifts off. So that's fine. Obviously, I cut the motor out already. There's an earth strap, and then this mechanism here, gear on this side, driven by the synchronous motor, and that just moves some cams around basically that interact with these two micro switches. So it's quite clever, really, the way these work. They use the fact that a synchronous motor, AC synchronous motor, such as this. If you put DC on it, it stalls and stays where it is. So on this back plate, there's a diode here, just a jelly bean diode and a couple of resistors, and that's all there is basically. But one of these switches, I forget which is which now, but one's for hot water only, and the other's both together, I think, or some combination of those. Anyway. Once one of these is pressed, it will engage this diode, put it into the circuit to the motor, and essentially just stall it. So you can stall the motor at the halfway position. I think if it's fully driven, then it turns on the radiators, so radiators only. But if it's stalled before being fully open, then you can fix it in a both together, heating and radiators, or just heating. And all the time, if there's no power on the synchronous motor, then this heavy spring draws it back around into the upper position. So yeah, pretty clever stuff. So in this case, it seemed to be the one of these switches has failed. So normally it seems to be the motor, and I was hoping that it might be, in which case you can replace these. But so in this instance, couldn't do that. Just to close this off, these are the two switches I've taken off. This is the good one. That rings through. That doesn't until I press the contact shut. Whereas this one is open circuit there, and it does indeed close circuit there, but looks like this contact isn't connected any longer. So I think that's why the switch failed. Or the power head failed. Just another aside on this board, so the wires all come into these connections here. But I just cracked the end off this one just to see whether it's possible to manipulate perhaps this in some way to get the wires out. And I think in fact you can, if you push through these rectangular openings with something sharp, you can push down this leaf potentially. It's a sort of barb. In fact, there's a spring leaf, if you can see on the camera there, sticking up at this angle, and that presses up against this upper surface. So as the wire is pushed in, which has got a crimped end on it, it just pushes in and grabs. So you should be able to push through here, if I could find the right one, and maybe push the wire and the leaf down, and you could potentially get it out. So I think you could get these leads out and replace them. It's not easy though. It's obviously not really designed as a reusable connection. It's a one-time fit. Anyway, that might be helpful to somebody. If they can replace the motor, for example, then I think it would be good to be able to get these wires out and put new ones in, rather than cutting the wire and soldering it or something. And finally, so I can get this faulty switch apart. There we go. See if there's any physically obvious thing that has caused it to fail. Let's try and get this end off as well. Right. So I've lost the operating lever, but yeah. So this contact wasn't connected. Normally closed. There's a little pip. Yeah, it's not. Oops. So that contact there, I guess, wasn't making connection to the moving part of the switch, and it does look quite black. I guess it just burnt the contact. This one that was making contact when the switch operated, that's slightly black, but nowhere near as comprehensively blackened as this one is. Yeah. I mean, these switches are normally really reliable, so I'm surprised that it's gone, but evidently it had the normally open contact had failed, or gone high resistance at least. Right. Thanks for watching.